Hello friends, welcome to Fun Learning. So if you want to prep up and crack competitive exams like the Olympiads, ASET or any talent search exam, well, this is the place for you. So do subscribe to our channel where we bring you last year papers and also challenging questions to help you prepare for these upcoming exams. In this video, we are going to solve the ASET science paper for class 3, which was held in winter 2019. The questions in this paper are good even if you're appearing for Olympiads or other talent search exams. So let's get started. The first question reads, Tanya could see her own face when she looked at an object. Which of these could the object be? Is it option A, brick wall? Is it option B, blackboard? Is it option C, white paper sheet, or option D, stainless steel plate? Your time starts now. Well, if you look at all the objects, you'll notice that it is only the stainless steel which is reflective because of its reflective surface. Hence, you can see your face or it'll appear as a mirror when the object chosen is D, stainless steel plate. So that's the right answer. Next question. In which part of this refrigerator can ice cream be stored without melting? Is it part A, part B, part C, or part D? Your time starts now. Well, I'm sure you'll get this answer right. But before getting to the answer, let me explain you the basics. Now, the only difference between a freezer and a refrigerator is the temperature controller, which is also called the thermostat. And what does this do? So, a freezer is designed to hold food at minus 18 degrees or below, and a refrigerator is designed to hold food between 0 and 5 degrees. And ice cream, as the name suggests, needs to be frozen below 0 degrees. Hence, it has to be kept in option A, the freezer. Next question. Some kitchen tools are shown below. Which of them is the best for serving soup from a pot? Is it option A, option B, option C, or option D? Your time starts now. Let's look at this together. So to serve spoon, you need a spoon without any holes, which is not flat and has depth. And this kind of a spoon is called a ladle. And this matches our answer in option D. So our right answer is option D. Next question. Four animals are shown below: butterfly, crow, duck, and the black ant. Which of the following statements is true for all of them? Option A, they can fly. Option B, they can walk. Option C, they have a beak. Or option D, they have feathers. Your time starts now. Well, let's look at this together. Now, talking about option A, they can fly. So if you look at it, it is the butterfly, crow and duck that can fly. And crow and duck have feathers. Well, not all. So option A and option D can be eliminated. Let's look at the beak now. Now, it is both crow and duck which have the beak. Beak is their mouth, as you can see here. So not even option C is true for all, leaving us with walk, which is true for all of these images shown here. So each of these animals can walk. Hence, the right answer is option B, they can walk. Next question. When dropped from a height onto a concrete floor, which of these is likely to make a sound for the longest time? Is it option A, the brick, option B, the coin, option C, the note, or option D, ball of wool? Your time starts now. Well, if you drop a brick from a height, it will break with a single impact and a single sound like thud. A notebook also since it is heavy, just a sound, and ball of wool, well, that is so light that you will not have sound, leaving us with option B, coin, which will make a sound for the longest time because circular nature and a thicker rim than the center will just spin till it comes to rest and settle. Next question. Maya saw a big banyan tree near her school. Which of the following would she have observed about the tree? Option A, fruits as large as her palm. Option B, leaves with rough toothed edges. Option C, roots hanging from the branches. Or option D, a green trunk supporting its branches. Your time starts now. Well, first let's look at the banyan tree, and what strikes most about it are these roots hanging from its branches. So option C, roots hanging from the branches, is the right option. And kids, another important information is banyan tree is the national tree of India. Next question. Cane measures the length of the shadow of a stick in the setup shown below. Something like this. This is the stick. When he puts the torch on, the shadow created is something shown in the horizontal line here. He now keeps a longer stick in the same place. In which direction should he move the torch to keep the length of the shadow the same as before? Is it option A, downwards? Is it option B, sideways? Is it option C, sideways again but to the left side? Or option D, it is not possible to keep the length of the shadow the same. Your time starts now. Before we answer this, let's learn a bit about light and shadows. So when light falls on an object, the shadow is formed on the other side. So as the light moves downwards or upwards, the shadow of the image changes. Similarly, when the light moves sideways, the shadow changes as well. So the movement of the light, whether a small angle or large angle, determines the size of the shadow, whether it will be short or long. So the right answer is option D, that it is not possible to keep the length of the shadow the same. Next question. Rubina made the statement about animals. All animals that eat other animals have sharp teeth. Which of these animals prove that Rubina's statement is wrong? Is it option A, leopard? Is it option B, buffalo? Is it option C, the eagle? Or option D, honeybee? Your time starts now. Now, leopard or eagle are the only animals in the picture here who eat other animals. The buffalo is herbivorous and so is the honeybee. So, now among these two, leopard definitely has sharp teeth. But the eagle, it does not have any sharp teeth. In fact, it has only a pointed beak to tear the flesh of the other animal that it is about to eat. So, the right answer is option C, the eagle. Next question. Which of the following contains food items obtained from both plant and animal sources? Is it option A, milk and toast? Is it option B, honey and curds? Is it option C, boiled egg and cheese? Or option D, orange juice and potato wafers? Your time starts now. If you look at all these options, option A is the right answer because milk is something that comes from animals, from the milking animals. Hence, it is coming from an animal source. And toast is something that is created by bread. And this bread is made out of flour, and this flour is extracted out of the plants like paddy, maize, bajra, etc. So this is a plant source. That is why option A is a combination of animal source and plant source. Next question. What is common to these parts of the human body? Eyes, ears, nose, nails. A. They are found in pairs. B. They are all seen on the head. C. They can be seen outside the body. Or D. They help us to know our surroundings. Your time starts now. So we have eyes which are in pair. We have nose which is just one in number. We have ears which are in pair. And we have nails. Now these body parts are not all in pairs, and also they are not all in the face. The nails are in the hands. But what is common is that they can be seen outside the body. Hence our right answer is option C. The time of a day is shown by the clock below. Which of the following shows the positions of the hands of the clock after 1 hour? Is it option A? Is it option B? Is it option C? Or option D? Your time starts now. Well, let's look at this together. Now, when we are looking at the clock after 1 hour, given this is the time now, after 1 hour, the minute hand will remain where it is, but the hour hand will move by one block. So that is, now it is between 1 and 2. After 1 hour, it will be between 2 and 3, and hence our right answer is option B, that is 2:30. Next question. This picture is of a vegetable cut in half. Which vegetable is it? Is it option A, beetroot? Option B, cabbage? Option C, brinjal? Or option D, onion? Your time starts now. Well, the right answer for this is onion. Yes, this is an onion that is cut into half. Next question. Study this map of Rita's neighborhood and answer the question. Rita leaves her house and turns right onto the North Street. She turns left and walks down Easy Street and turns left on the South Street. What will she now see on her right? Is it option A, the ice cream shop? Is it option B, the swimming pool? Is it option C, the post office? Or option D, the hospital? Read the question again and then choose the right answer. Well, let's look at this together. Now, let's read the instructions one by one. So, here we have Rita. She is leaving her house facing this side. Now, Rita leaves her house and turns right onto the North Street. So, where Rita is standing, her right is on this side. So she turns right on North Street, then she turns left and walks down Easy Street. Okay, so she turns left and walks down Easy Street, and then she turns left on the South Street. So turning left on the South Street, this is where Rita is facing this side. Now what will come to her right? Well, these are her right and left directions, and it is the hospital which is on her right. Hence that is the right answer, option D. Next question. Farida cooked a full bowl of raw rice shown below. After it is cooked in water, what will be true about the space the rice will take up? A. It will take up less space. B. It will take up more space. C. It will take up the same space. Or D. Cannot say, as it depends on how long it takes to cook. Choose your right answer. Your time starts now. Well, let me show you something. I hope you've been helping your mama in the kitchen, because then you can choose the right answer quickly. Well, the right answer for this is option B. It takes up more space, because when you take a bowl of rice and put it in a pressure cooker or boiling water, it soaks up that water and fluffs up and takes up more space. So you see, one bowl converts into so much rice. Next question. Roger's new pencil weighs 6 grams. He now sharpens his pencil and collects all the shavings. What will be the weight of the sharpened pencil together with all its shavings? Is it option A, 6 grams? Is it option B less than 6 grams? Is it option C more than 6 grams? Or option D, it depends on how much it is sharpened. Your time starts now. Well, when you sharpen it, this is the pencil shavings, but along with the pencil shavings, you also have the lead that comes in form of a powder which is lost. Hence, we lose some weight when we sharpen a pencil. That is why the weight of the sharpened pencil together with all its shavings, which is this only, would be less than 6 grams. Hence, the answer is option B. So with that, we come to the end of our first section. Let's take a break and hit on the video link given in the description box. Well, I hope you were able to solve most of the questions easily and quickly. If you need more practice, go to our playlist where you'll find a lot of practice questions and other papers for your grade. So till we meet again, take care.